Let's build a giant fantasy-style mansion. Hey guys, Big Tony here, and today I'm going to show you how to build this big mansion block by block, inside and out. This video will be just the outside, and then the next video will build the interior. And the inside was designed by a couple of my friends, AdmirablesMC and Mr. Marvel. I'll have links to both of their pages in the description. I'll give you a full tour of the inside in the interior video, but for now, let's get down to business. So here's the layout we'll be using. Go ahead and start by just building this in the ground using whatever blocks you want. The materials list will be in the description, but before you go out and collect the materials, let me show you some options for this house. So we're using copper for the roof of this house, and obviously you have a couple of options for the colors. If you're in survival, you'll have to start by using the regular orange copper. And if you like the orange look, you can wax it all so it stays that way. But I do recommend letting some of it oxidize to this first stage before you wax it, just for some variation. My recommendation though would be to let it oxidize all the way into this blue color. Although I do recommend waxing some of it at the weathered stage, again, just for some variation. Okay, so now let's talk texturing. For all the parts that I built out of stone bricks in the tutorial, I recommend mixing in some cracked stone brick and sprinkling in a little bit of polished andesite. And I also recommend mixing in some of this mossy stone bricks only where you have leaves or vines. And then for our upper walls, I recommend mixing in some regular sandstone with the smooth sandstone. Now all of this texturing is optional and it's not included on the materials list, but it'll make your house look a whole lot better. Okay, so I think we're ready to start now, and here I have the layout in place. And we'll start with some chiseled stone bricks on this front side. Place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, skip 3 for a doorway, and then place 6 more. Then we're going to build up with stone bricks an additional 9 blocks for a total of 10. And before we fill in this wall, let's build up our doorway, so the doorway will be 3x5. So we have 3 across and then 5 tall. Then we'll go ahead and fill up this wall with stone bricks to a total of 10 blocks high, so that's 9 on top of the chiseled stone bricks. Next we can place our door in there, starting with one spruce door. Then we'll surround that using spruce trapdoors. So again, it should be 5 blocks tall and 3 blocks wide. And the trapdoor should be on this side of the block, so if you go on the front side, this should be completely flat. Alright, so next we'll place a stone brick here on the end. Then skip 3 and place another stone brick. Then we'll skip 5 and place another, and then 3 and one more. Now we're going to build these up to that height of 10. Then we'll go across and build this one up as well. Then at the top here we'll place 2 upside down stairs to form an archway. Now we're going to repeat this on the other side, so we'll build those stone brick pillars up. 3 more across the top and then 2 upside down stairs. Now for our doorway we'll start with a chiseled stone brick on the ground. Then build up a stone brick. Near the top of those trap doors, place 2 upside down stairs, so those stairs are on the 5th block up. Now from here we'll fill in everything else with stone bricks up to that height of 10. Next we're just going to repeat this block for block on the backside. So we'll start with our 6 chiseled stone bricks, skip 3 and place 6 more. Then we'll build that stone brick up an additional 9 for a total of 10, just leaving that 3x5 gap for the door. Then we'll fill in our door using one spruce door and then surrounding that with trapdoors. Then on this end we'll place 10 stone bricks going up to the top. Go across here and then build this one up as well, 3 blocks over. 2 upside down stairs at the top to make it an arch, and then we'll repeat this on the other side. Then here we'll place a chiseled stone brick on each side at the bottom. Then we'll go up with the stone bricks and place 2 upside down stairs at the top of those trap doors. And then we'll fill in the rest with stone bricks. Now on each side there's these little extensions here. Let's switch over to a world with a finished house so I can show you, because you have a couple of options. So on my build I used this covered entrance with a roof on the front side. And then on the back side I made this balcony. But if you want to, you can switch them up so you can put the balcony on the front and then the covered entrance on the back. It's up to you. So we're going to start with a covered entrance with a roof, and I'm on the front side, but you can build this on the back side if you want. And we're going to build up 7 stone brick blocks and then connect it across here. Build up 7 on this block too, and again we'll connect it. Then we're going to fill this all in with stone brick walls on both sides. Then we're going to place 5 walls on each side on the front. Place a block on top of each wall, and then a slab leading off from that full block. Now on each side we're going to place 2 stairs on top of the full block and slab facing towards the center. So just like that, and we'll do this on the other side. In the center we'll place a slab. Then on each side we'll place a full block, 1 block in from the outside. Then using a placeholder block I'll place 1 upside down stair. Just like that. We'll do the same thing on this side, so we'll need a placeholder block and then an upside down stair. Break that one in the center. Then right here I'll place a chiseled stone brick. My original design uses a respawn anchor, but obviously that's not very practical. Anyway, next we'll place a full block on each side with a slab in between. So this is what the pattern should look like from the inside. And then that's it, we just have to put a roof on it later. Okay, so now for our balcony, which I'll put on the back side. Start by placing 10 stone brick blocks on each of these white squares. Next we're going to make some archways, so on the 7th block up, place an upside down stair. Then on this side we'll place another. Place 2 stone brick blocks on each side and then a slab in between. So that's what our archway looks like, and we'll repeat this on the remaining 3 sides. So 2 upside down stairs and then 4 stone brick blocks with a slab in between. And we'll do it again on this final side. Next, place 2 full stone brick blocks in the center of each of these 5 block gaps. Then place 2 upside down stairs in the remaining spaces. Then we'll fill in the floor 1 block below the top, so that's the 9th level, with stone bricks. Now in between all these blocks, we'll place stone brick walls. Then we'll need a door to get out to this balcony, so break this block right here, and then these 3 on the inside. We'll place a spruce door on there from the inside. Then we'll build up 2 stone bricks on each side with an upside down stair above the door. And that's it for our balcony. Next we're going to continue building up the stone brick walls for the base of our house. Let's start with our 2 towers on the 2 front corners, because everything else will be the same height. So let's start by placing some chiseled stone bricks on the ground on these blocks like so. Then this part will be 2 blocks higher than over there, so we'll build it up an additional 11 for a total of 12. Okay, so now let's start adding our arches. On this block right here, we'll go all the way up with stone bricks. No chiseled stone brick at the bottom. Go across to the top and then we'll build this one all the way up. And where they intersect, I'm actually going to place chiseled stone bricks. Then we'll place 2 upside down stairs to turn that into an arch. Now we're basically just going to repeat this all the way around. So build these 2 pillars up with a chiseled stone brick at the top. 3 stone bricks across the top on each section, and then 2 upside down stairs for each section to make it an arch. Now let's do it on this side. Now this final side will get cut off by the rest of the house, so we'll just place 2 stone bricks and then 1 upside down stair. And now we're just going to repeat this on the other tower. Okay, so now let's go back around to the front. And we're going to build those final wall sections on the front side. You can start on either one, they're both going to be the exact same. So let's just go right here and place our chiseled stone bricks down. Then we'll build up our stone bricks an additional 7 for a total of 8. And here I accidentally built it up one block short. So let's place one layer of stone bricks going all the way across. You can build these two up to a total of 8. And then this one too. Then on this side we're gonna have some windows. So in the center of those 4 block wide gaps between the archways, we'll have 2 block wide windows. So let's go to this window and we'll build up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we'll place a stone brick stair there. So the window will be 4 full blocks tall, plus an extra little bit where that stair is. Then we'll build up the stone brick around the window. 2 more upside down stairs here. And then as I mentioned before, I built it up 1 block short, so we need 1 more layer of stone bricks. So here you just see me measuring and seeing that I built it up 1 block short. Okay, so just to be sure we got this right, it's 1 layer of chiseled stone brick and then 1 layer of stone brick all the way across. 4 blocks tall with windows, and then on the 5th block of that window, place upside down stairs, and then 1 more layer of stone bricks. Okay, so for these outside arches, we'll build it up on these blocks all the way up, and go across with the stone bricks. And we'll build these other two up as well. Then in each section, place an upside down stone brick stair on each side to make arches. And then we're done with this section. Now we're going to repeat it block for block on the other side. Okay, now we just have our back walls to do. And all of the remaining walls will be a total of 8 blocks tall, just like the sections we just did. So on our two sides, you should have 3 block gap, and then 4 block gap, and then a 3. And on the very back side, they should all be 4 block wide gaps. So let's place our chiseled stone bricks on the bottom here. Then on the sides, we'll have no windows, so you can just build this up an additional 7 with stone bricks. Let's go ahead and fill this in now. Then for our arches, we'll build it up 8 blocks tall with stone bricks. And go across the tops. And then 2 upside down stone brick stairs on each side. So this should be 4 blocks shorter than the tower. Okay, so now let's go over to the back side. And this time we're going to have windows again, so let's start by placing 1 layer of stone bricks. Then we'll have a 2 block wide window in the center of each of these 4 block wide arch sections. So now we'll just build up around the windows to a total of 8 blocks tall. Place stone bricks across the top. Then on the 7th block up, we'll place 2 upside down stairs to make those windows into arches. And for the outer arches, we're just doing it the same way that we've been doing, so I won't explain it. Alright, so now all that's left for our stone brick walls is to repeat this exactly on the other side. Okay, so now our stone brick base is completed, and next we'll build our sandstone and wooden upper walls. So we'll start on the front side and at the top of the stone brick place a stair on the end, then a trapdoor and then a slab, trapdoor, stair, and then one more trapdoor, so it should look like that. Then we'll do the same thing on the other side. Then on this stair we'll place a 9-block tall oak log. And place one more sideways log going off from here. Then we'll have a sideways log going all the way across this front side. Then on this stair, another 9-block tall oak log. And one more sideways stair going off here. Right in the center, we'll build up a 12-block tall oak log. Then one block above this log, we'll have a sideways log going across. So there should be 3 more logs at the top. Then we'll place one on the other side as well. At the bottom, we'll place upside down spruce stairs on each side. Then in the top corner of each side, we'll place an upside down spruce stair. And 2 trapdoors like so. Next, we'll make some flower boxes on top of these upside down stairs, so place 4 grass blocks on each side. Then surround the outer sides with oak trapdoors. Then I'm going to place some sweet berry bushes in the flower box, but you can also use whatever flowers or plants you want. Then from the inside, I'll place 4 spruce planks next to that grass. Then we'll go around the edges using smooth sandstone. So it should look like this. Then inside here, we'll place 4 trapdoors. Then 4 more facing this direction, so when you flip them, it should look like this. Then we'll place 4 more against this wall and 4 more against these trapdoors in the center. Then we'll place 4 stairs to make 2 arches like so. Next we'll place some full glass blocks 1 block back. And now we're going to repeat this window on the other side. Okay, so now we'll make a little roof over the windows on the outside. So place a slab on each side and then 4 trapdoors like so. And we'll do this on both sides. Next in this upper corner we'll place a stair and then upside down stair, another stair and upside down stair, and then one more stair, so you should have three normal stairs and two upside down stairs. Then we'll use a placeholder block right here and place an upside down stair. So it should be one block inwards, another placeholder block and one more upside down stair. So it should look like this. Then we're going to repeat this on the other side. So again, three normal stairs and two upside down stairs, like so. Up here we're going to have a 7 block long horizontal log. Placeholder block and an upside down stair, and then another placeholder block with an upside down stair. So this is what you should have now. Then up top here, one block inwards, we'll place a spruce plank on each side, and then a stair, and a trapdoor in between. Then we'll build that plank up another level, so you should have two planks on each side, and a trapdoor on that plank. Next we'll use a placeholder block to place an upside down stair, so we're going to have a circular window here. We'll do that on both sides. A trapdoor in between, and then we'll place three more spruce planks on top, and two more on top of that. Next we'll go back a layer, and we're going to fill this in with smooth sandstone, just filling in the holes. In this circular window, we'll place a 3x3 of glass blocks. And I'm just going to place some extra sandstone around the window. So the reason I'm not filling all of this in with sandstone is because the glass blocks stick out a level, so you can use different blocks for the inside. And that would mean that you won't be able to see that sandstone, so it'd just be wasted. Okay, next let's build up the left side on the front. So we'll place a stair here, a stair in the center, and then one more on this side. And we'll place some trapdoors in between. Then we'll build up logs on top of those stairs, 9 blocks tall. And we'll go across here with a sideways log and at the bottom. So this center log will only be 7 blocks. Next we'll place upside down stairs at the bottom. And then in each corner we'll place an upside down stair and 2 trapdoors. Again, we're going to make some flower boxes, but this time it'll just be 2 grass blocks on each side. And again, we'll surround the outer sides with trapdoors. I'll place those sweet berries in there. Then let's go on the inside, we'll place 2 spruce planks next to those grass blocks, and then surround the outsides with smooth sandstone. Then we'll place 2 upside down stairs at the top and 3 trapdoors on each side. And then we'll place glass blocks behind. So let's do the same thing on the other side. Place smooth sandstone around the outside. 2 upside down stairs at the top. And 3 trapdoors on each side. Then we'll place 8 glass blocks on the backside. Alright, so that's what it should look like. Then we can just place 6 smooth sandstone here to close this off. And now let's go ahead and repeat this wall section on the right side. Okay, so now we're going to build up our towers, and again it's going to be the exact same for both sides. Let's start by building up a 12 block tall oak log in the corner, and these don't extend out, so it's just straight on top of the stone brick. Then we'll place a sideways log going across, and another 12 block log on the corner. Then in the center we'll build up a 7 block tall oak log. And one block above that we'll place a horizontal log going across. So there should be 3 more blocks at the top. Down here we'll place 3 upside down stairs in each section. Then in all the corners we'll place 2 stairs and 3 trapdoors. Just like this. And there's no flower boxes for the towers, so we'll just go on the inside here. And we're going to fill this in with smooth sandstone with a 4 block tall, 1 block wide glass pane window, right in the center. So we'll do that for both sides. Now this side is going to be exactly the same as the front side. So place a sideways log going across and then a 12 block tall oak log. In line with this one, we'll place a horizontal log going across, and then a 7 block tall oak log in the center. Place your upside down stairs at the bottom. Then in the corners, place upside down stairs and 3 trapdoors on each side. Then we'll fill this in with our sandstone, again 4x1 windows in the center, using glass panes. Then right here, which is the far right side of the house, we'll place a log with 1 block of space between that other log. Then we'll place 2 oak logs 1 block away from the sides, and we'll fill in these spaces with spruce fences. And on the inside, I'm going to place planks behind the fences. So it should look like this. Don't do it on the front side, but we will do it on this side. So first of all, place 4 sideways logs here. Then we'll build up a vertical log 7 blocks tall. Then we'll have this sideways log going across. And we'll use a placeholder block to place that vertical log. Then we'll take a horizontal log going across. Here we'll just place 2 horizontal logs, then 2 upside down stairs. And here we'll place 1 stair and 2 trapdoors. Then we'll fill in one more layer of sandstone right here with no window. Then for this part, we'll start with our 3 upside down stairs. Then fill this in with sandstone, leaving a 4x1 window. And on this side, we'll place 2 stairs and then 3 trapdoors. Place 1 plank right here. Then on this side, we're going to repeat what we did on the other side. So build up this vertical log. Then we'll place a horizontal log and 2 more vertical logs down here. Then we'll fill in the gaps with fences and place some planks behind. Now on each side of the front of the house, place a 4 block tall oak log. And then here we're going to have a big clock, but you can also replace the clock with glass to make it a circular window. So in each of these corners, place a stair if you're doing the clock. And if you're doing the window, you can also place some trapdoors, but you can't place the trapdoors if you're doing the clock. So anyway, next, 3 blocks up, we'll place a placeholder block and then another upside down stair in each corner. So it should look like this. Then we'll have a horizontal log going across. Then place a 4 block tall vertical log with 2 planks on each side. Now for the clock face, we're going to fill in this 5x5 area with a mixture of calcite and diorite. And in the center, I'm going to place a chiseled stone brick. Now to decorate our clock face, I'm going to use 3 dark oak fences. And you can also use fence gates if you want to show a different time. Then I'll place 3 blackstone buttons on each side. Alright, so now on the back side, we'll start off the same way with 4 oak logs on each side. Then at the top we'll place a placeholder block with an upside down stair. Then we'll place 2 trapdoors on each one. Here we'll have our 5 block wide horizontal log. Then 2 vertical logs on top with 2 planks on each side. Now on this side, instead of the clock face, we're going to fill this in with our smooth sandstone. Okay. Okay, so now we're just going to go ahead and repeat this exactly on the other side. Okay, so now that we got our two towers in place, we're gonna start working on the walls on the back side of the house. So you can start on either side, they'll both be the exact same. I'll start on the right side, and in line with these stone brick columns, at the top of the stone brick, place an upside down stair with trapdoors in between. And let's go over to this side and we'll build up a 10 block tall vertical log. Then on the other side, we're gonna build an 11 block tall vertical log. So it should be one block taller, and then at the top here we'll have a horizontal log going all the way across. We'll have one going across at the bottom too. Next, above those upside down stairs, we'll build up two 7 block tall oak logs. Then with one block of space, we'll have another horizontal log going across. And here we're going to place a vertical log every other block. So on one side you're going to have a double log, it doesn't really matter which, but on my design I had the double log towards the backside. Next, in each of these archways, we'll place an upside down stair in the corners. And then some spruce trapdoors to round it out. Then at the bottoms, we'll have upside down stairs going across. Then in all of these little holes, I'll place spruce fences. And on the inside, I'll place a plank behind each fence. Then we'll start filling in our sandstone for the walls, and for the two 3-block wide sections, we'll have a 1-wide, 4-tall window with glass panes. And then on the outside, we'll have some oak leaves hanging from these shelves. And that's just on the two 3-block wide sections. For our 4-block wide section, we'll have a flower box, so we'll start with two grass blocks. Then two planks behind, then we'll take the smooth sandstone around the outsides. For the window, we'll place two upside down stairs at the top and then three trapdoors on each side. And then we'll place full glass blocks behind. And for our flower box, we'll take these oak trapdoors and sweet berries. Place the sweet berries on the grass and surround it with oak trapdoors. Now from the side of this 2-block wide window that's towards the back of the house, we'll go straight up and build a 6-block tall oak log. Then skip 3 towards the front and build another 6-block tall oak log. Next we'll place an upside down stair with a stair on top. Another upside down stair, one more stair and then a full block next to it. And where this wall connects with the tower, I'll place one more upside down stair right here. And we actually need one more sandstone block right here. Alright, so now on the other side, we'll place an upside down stair and stair. We'll keep going until you have two upside down stairs and two normal stairs, and then we'll place a plank on the end. Next on the edge here, place a placeholder block and then an upside down stair. And then another placeholder block with an upside down stair. So it should be going one block inwards with each level. Up here, another placeholder block and upside down stair. And one more time. Then at the top of these logs, place two upside down stairs in the corners and then three trapdoors. We'll have three sideways logs going across the top and then one plank at the very top. Here again, we'll go down with those upside down stairs, using placeholder blocks to place them. At the bottom of this arch, let's place three upside down stairs, and then I'll have some oak leaves hanging off from it. Now I'll fill this wall in with sandstone, but with a 1x3 window of glass panes. And then we'll fill in the sides with smooth sandstone as well. Okay, so this is what it should look like. And now while it's still fresh in our minds, let's go over to the other side and repeat it. So next we have the back sides, and they're pretty simple. It's basically the same thing that we did on the front sides over there. So let's start by placing an upside down stair at the top of those stone break columns, and go ahead and place trapdoors in between. Then on the end here we'll place 10 vertical logs, so it should be one block shorter than that one. On this side we'll place a 9 block tall vertical log, then we'll go across with the horizontal log at the bottom. Then above these two inside stairs, we'll build up 7 blocks. And we'll have a horizontal log going across the top. So this log should stick up by 1. Then in the tops of the arches and the corners, we'll place upside down stairs. And 2 trapdoors for each stair. We'll place our upside down stairs along the bottom. Then we'll have our 2-block wide flower boxes, so place down 2 grass, and then berries on top of the grass. And then we'll surround the grass using oak trapdoors. On the inside, we'll place spruce planks on those grass blocks. Then we'll go around the edges with our smooth sandstone. Then for each window, we'll place 2 upside down stairs at the top. And then 3 trapdoors on each side. And then we'll place our full glass blocks behind. Alright, so that's all there is for this wall section, and again we're going to repeat this on the other side. Thank you. Okay, so now all that we have left is our very back wall, and this will be pretty similar to the front side but with a few differences just for the balcony. So let's start on the left side with an upside down stair, trapdoor, and then a slab and another trapdoor. Then we'll do the same for the other side. Up here we're going to build up a 9 block tall oak log. And we'll do the same on the other side. Down here we're going to place 5 sideways logs on each side. Then we'll place 1 vertical log on each side. Then we're going to place 3 trapdoors on each side. Then we'll use some placeholder blocks to get an upside down stair above those trapdoors. Again, we'll do it on both sides. Then place a stair on top of those upside down stairs. And we'll place a trapdoor in between the upside down stairs. Then we'll build up 10 logs on top of that trapdoor. And above the door, we're actually going to need 3 more stone bricks. So 1 block above those side logs, we're going to have a sideways log going across and stop it 1 block short. We'll do it on both sides. Then in the corners, place an upside down stair. And 2 trapdoors for each stair. At the bottom, you can place some upside down stairs going across. Then there's no flower boxes, but we're still going to have 4 spruce planks on each side of that stone brick. Then we'll take some sandstone around the edges. Now we're going to copy those window details from the front side. So place your spruce trapdoors in there, 4 blocks tall. And then flip them all. And at the top we'll place upside down stairs to make those arches. They should look like this. Then we'll have our full glass blocks on the inside. Now we'll repeat this on the other side. Okay, so now for the shelves on the outside. Instead of a flower box, I'm just going to have some leaves draping over. Of course, if you'd rather, you can also do the flower box. Okay, so for the upper part of this wall, it'll be the same as the front side. So let's start with a stair and then alternate stairs and upside down stairs until you have 3 regular stairs and 2 upside down stairs. So now let's do this on the other side. Then we'll use a placeholder block to get a sideways log going across, 7 blocks wide. Here we'll use a placeholder block to get an upside down stair. And one more. It should look like this. Same on the other side. Up at the top here, we'll make a circular window like over there. So place 2 spruce planks on each side, then a stair on each side at the bottom, then a trapdoor in between and 1 more on each side. Then we'll use a placeholder block to get another upside down stair on both sides, trapdoor in between, then 3 planks on top and 2 more. Now from the inside, we're going to start filling this in with our sandstone. And for the window, I'll have a 3x3 of glass blocks. Then I'll surround the edges with sandstone. And now we're all done with our walls and ready to build the roof. So for our roof, let's go around to the front side to start, and we'll build the roof for this little covered entrance. So let's start with a trapdoor here, and then a slab, and alternating trapdoors and slabs. So the slab will stick out by 1. And now we'll repeat this on the other side. Now on the end here, we'll place another slab and then a full block next to it. Then another slab on each side. And now we're going to increase the slope with a stair. Then an upside down stair on each side. Another stair. And in the center we'll place an upside down stair and then a full block on top. Now from here we're going to alternate full blocks and slabs. So now we're just going to fill in the roof with our copper, just following that frame. And let's also go underneath and clean up the roof a little bit. So I'll start by just placing some stairs on each side. Then at the top I'll place spruce planks. Then I'm also going to place three chains and a lantern. Okay, so now let's go around the entire house and build all of our frames, and then we'll fill it in afterwards. So start on this front side. One block below the top, place a slab and extend that out by one. Then we'll start by going up with stairs and upside down stairs until you have four normal stairs. So that's four normal stairs right there. One more upside down stair and then we'll place a full block. And from here we're going to go up with a steeper slope, just placing full blocks under the stairs. Then once you get to the center, we'll place an upside down stair and then two full blocks on top. Now we're going to repeat this on the other side. So start with our two slabs, one block below the top. Then we'll go up with stairs and upside down stairs until you have four normal stairs. One more upside down stair and then we'll go up with our steeper slope. And there we have it. Now I'll go over to the sides, and we'll just place slabs going across at the top of that log. And you can just skip the end here. Next we'll build a frame for our towers. So start with slabs, one block below the top, and extend that out by one. Then we'll go up with stairs until you have two stairs. One more upside down stair, and then we'll go up with full blocks and stairs. Once you get to the top, an upside down stair and then two full blocks. Then we're just going to go back down. So from here we'll place the slabs and we'll just go all the way across the side here. Then we'll repeat the frame on this side. And again, we'll take these slabs all the way across. So that's our wooden frame for the tower. Now on this side, we'll have slabs going across one block from the top. And our frame for this side is just going to be all stairs and upside down stairs. There's no steeper slope. And you can also place an extra upside down stair here just to fill in that hole. So at the top, we'll just place that upside down stair and then a full block on top. Over on this side, we're just going to take these slabs all the way across. And I just realized I forgot to fill in these gaps, so you can just place 7 sandstone on each side if you haven't already. So our frame for the back side will be the exact same as the front side, so you can just copy that over here. And well, the rest of our frames are also just mirrored from the other side, so I'll stop talking now. Okay, so now that we have all of our frames in place, it's just a matter of following those frames with copper to fill in the roof. And at the tops of the frames, we're just gonna go across with alternating spruce planks and slabs. And there's not really much more explaining I can do here, so I'll save my voice and I'll be back in a bit. So now we just have some more details to add to our roof. On the front and back side, I'm going to place an anvil, then a cobbled deepslate wall with a dark oak fence, and finally an iron bar. And we're going to do this on the back side as well. And now we're just going to add in some dormers and a chimney to our roof. So let's start with a dormer on our front side. 4 blocks over from the tower and 3 blocks up will break this one. So there should be 2 stairs below and 3 to the left. We'll use some placeholder blocks to get a vertical log there. And build it up 5 blocks tall. Break these 3 and place 3 grass in their place. We'll use another placeholder block to get a vertical log. And again we'll build it up 5 blocks tall. You can break out these stairs behind and we'll place some sandstone. We'll build it up 4x3 with a 2x1 window in the center. Then place 3 fence gates across the top. Use a placeholder block to get 3 sideways logs on top of those fence gates. And then one more plank on top. Now one block below the top will have slabs going across and extend out by 1. The frame of our roof will just go up with stairs and upside down stairs. And in the center we'll have an upside down stair and a full block on top. Then from here we'll go across with alternating full blocks and slabs, just like we did with the rest of the roof. Now we'll just start filling this in with copper and connect it to the main roof. And for the sides here you can just fill in these holes with sandstone. So it should look like this from the outside. And let's finish filling in this roof. And again, we'll fill in this side of the wall too. And we'll steal some of these oak trapdoors and place them on the outside of this grass. So that's our dormer, and now you can just repeat this block for block on the other side. Now for the chimney, you can really place it on either side, it doesn't really matter, but I'll place mine on the left. So on this first row of full blocks, we'll go across and then over here and skip one stair and place it with stone bricks. We'll go across 3, and our chimney will be a 3x3, going back. So we'll fill this in so that on the front side you have 6 stone bricks sticking up, and we'll fill in the whole thing. Inside here, we'll place a hay bale with a campfire on top. Then at the top we're going to place upside down stairs going all the way around. Now our dormers on the backside will be a little bit different. And they'll be in line with the windows down below. So start by going up on the third copper stair and break that third one from the right. Place a vertical log there and then skip two blocks and place another. And two horizontal logs in between. We'll build those vertical logs up an additional three for a total of four. Then at the top we'll place two upside down stairs and two trapdoors on each side to make this arch. Then we'll use a placeholder block and place two more sideways logs at the top. Then we'll fill in the sides of these walls with spruce planks, just going over from those vertical logs. Then for our roof, we'll have two stairs sticking out. Then on top of that, we'll place two stairs facing in, two upside down stairs in between, and then two more stairs on top. Then we'll just connect our copper to this. And finally, on the inside, you can just place some glass blocks. So now we're going to have three of these, with one block of space in between each one, so they should line up with those windows down below. So again, on each side of those four block gaps, we'll place a vertical log and then two sideways logs in between. Build those vertical logs up an additional three for a total of four. Then we'll use a placeholder block to place two more sideways logs on each one. Then we'll use our trapdoors and stairs to make an arch. We can break out these stairs and place some glass behind. We'll fill in the side walls with spruce planks. Then for our roof, we'll start off with two upside down stairs on each one. Then we'll place our stairs and upside down stairs for the frame on top of those. And then we'll just connect the copper to the main roof. So there's our backside dormers, and as you probably guessed, we're going to repeat it on the other side. Okay, so now our roof is completely finished. I'm just gonna go off camera and do that texturing that I talked about at the beginning, and then we'll add in a few final details. So first of all, around the entryway at the front and the back of the house, I'm gonna replace some of this grass with mossy cobblestone. Now let's go around to the backside and do the same thing. I'll place a couple of lanterns up here on the balcony, and then down below I'll place 3 chains in the center, and then 2 chains on each side, and a lantern hanging from each chain. On the inside of the house for these lower windows with no glass, I'll make some shutters using spruce trapdoors. So you can make your shutters either open or closed, it doesn't really matter, but if you want to keep your house safe then you'll probably want them closed. So I'm just going to go around to each window and add some of these shutters, and I'm going to use a mixture of open and closed shutters. Okay, so next up we're going to add some oak leaves around the base, and wherever I put leaves I'm also going to add some mossy stone bricks around the leaves. Also for the towers I'm going to use oak leaves as vines, so we'll just kind of place them snaking up those bare sides. It's kind of hard to explain, but you'll see how I do it. So I'll just go all the way around the house now, and I'll put this on a faster speed. So we're using oak leaves and adding bushes around the base and vines around the towers. And then I'm adding some mossy stone bricks around the leaves. Okay, so now we're completely done with the exterior of this house. The interior video will be coming soon. It's gonna be a long video, so it'll probably take me a while to make it, but if you're watching this in the future, it's probably already out, in which case it'll be here on the screen. As always guys, thanks for watching, don't forget to leave a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.